Tom, what are some of the comparisons between what you've seen this ball club do as to what you saw in that year?
You know, it's a little bit different. The starting pitching wasn't strong then. It's not real strong now. But the expectations here for the offense this year were really good. And they're just not scoring runs like everyone thought they would this year. But back then, you know, we had Cal and Eddie and Ray Knight and some other guys. And we scored some runs, but we just gave up more. But they're not really offensively doing as well as they should this year.
Now, Tom, after the Orioles had gone 0-20 when they came back to Baltimore after a win in Chicago, I remember, and then they announced the fact that they were going to build Baltimore's Camden Yards. Memories of that night when they packed Memorial Stadium.
Well, you know what? They've always had great fans here in Baltimore, and it just showed we came back. I mean, it was just a horrible year, but they packed the place. I didn't know much about Baltimore when I got traded here. Thanks to our neighbor, Rick. He got me traded here. He's my workout buddy when I was with the Dodgers. But I enjoyed my year and a half here so much. We weren't real great, but I've gotten to be good friends with so many of the guys I played with. I get to do the Orioles fantasy camp now and do stuff, and they're just a real class organization.
Tom, you've seen a lot in the newspapers, on television, everything about all these new statistics that pitchers are coming up with. Tunneling a ball, which means throwing in the same spot two different pitches in a row. I don't think there's too many guys that can throw that same good pitch two times in a row. But what are you thinking about that as far as mechanics are concerned? Do you see that kind of stability?
It's gotten so systematic where it's just look where the catcher's glove is and throw it to it. You know, you knew what you were doing. You call a slider, you throw a fastball. I'm going to go with what you said, just like when I was with the Dodgers, Steve Yeager, the same thing. If you think you're going to lose, just like in golf, if you think things aren't going to go good, you can't overthink when you're on the mound. You know, you want to think one pitch ahead. If I'm throwing a fastball up and in, it's setting up the next pitch. But other than that, you don't want to overthink. You react to the batter's swing. It was very easy. I don't want to just go out there with a game plan. If I'm throwing a fastball and the batter's on my swing, I'm going to adjust and throw a slider. If he's not on my swing, I'm going to keep throwing fastballs.
How much of pitching depended on you reading a hitter? No matter what the scouting report said, when you see a hitter do a certain thing, did it make you change the way you pitched him?
All of it.
All of it.
All of it. I mean, there was a scouting report.
That was a test, and you passed it.
I could only do so much. I had a fastball 80% of the time and a little slider once in a while, so I couldn't go with the main scouting report. But even with my little slider, if they were on my fastball, I'm going to adjust. You know, and that's what it is. You got to pitch to your strengths and not the batter's weaknesses, believe in.
Kind of a little side story here. The two of them never played on the same Orioles team, but they're neighbors and they play golf a lot. Tom
Niedenfuer. He got me in shape in the wintertime. Try to block that slider in the wintertime.
I got a better one. When I was with the Cardinals, Rick was with the Dodgers. So he was my buddy. So I finally faced him. He was up to bat. And I threw him 0-0, 1-1, blah, blah. All the way to 2-2, I threw him 8 fastballs in a row. He fouled him back. And then I threw him a slider, and I punched him out, and he called me that night. He says, how can you throw me a damn slider?
I don't remember you punching me out.